Hello viewers, welcome to UN Digital Class. In today's lecture, I am going to discuss about speech recognition. Let us start. First of all, what is speech recognition? Speech recognition is also known as automatic speech recognition or computer speech recognition or speech to text, which means understanding voice by the computer and performing any required task. That means here speech recognition is also known as automatic speech recognition, and you can also call it as computer speech recognition, because here the computer recognizes the voice and according to that voice it performs the task. That is the speech recognition. Next, it develops methods and technology that implement the recognition and translation of spoken language into text by computers, which means in speech recognition we use the technology through which we can convert the voice into the text by computer. That is the main goal of speech recognition. Next, where we use this speech recognition technique? First one is the system control or navigation, for example GPS connected digital maps. That means suppose you are driving a car and at that timing you want to know the destination by using the Google Map. In this case you just give the voice input to the digital Google Map so that the digital Google Map recognize your voice, and according to your voice it gives you the path to your destination. That is the one application of the speech recognition. Next one is the commercial industrial application in the car steering system. Next, voice dialing hands-free use of mobile in the car. That means when you use your voice to call someone, this is also the speech recognition. In this case you just give the command, that is your contact name, and according to the contact name which number you saved, that number is automatically dialed. That is called as the voice dialing, and it is one of the application of the speech recognition. Next, working mechanism of speech recognition. In this working mechanism, here the input is the voice input. Then next, this voice input is converted into analog form to digital form. After the conversion from analog to digital, then this input is given through two model. One is the acoustic model, another one is the language model. Here the acoustic model is nothing but it is the sound model which detects the sound of our speech. Then the language model is nothing but it detects the language of our speech which is given input. After detecting the sound and the language, then it goes through the speech engine. The speech engine then takes the sound and the language and it forms the sentence or words. After that it displays the output. If there is any feedback, then this feedback again go to the speech engine. Then the speech engine performs tasks according to the feedback. This is the working mechanism or working principle of the speech recognition process. Next, what is an acoustic model? Here, an acoustic model is a file that consists of statistical representation of each of the distinguishable sounds that makes up a word. That means, I have already told you that acoustic model is nothing but it is the sound model which specifically detects the sound of our speech which given input to the system. Here the acoustic model says that it is a file which consists of the statistical representation of the sound which makes the word. Next, statistical representation assigned to the label called a phoneme. That means In acoustic model, the statistical representation is called as the poems. Next, the English language has approximately 40 different sounds used in speech recognition. Therefore, we have 40 different phonemes, which means in our English language, there is 40 different sounds. And all these 40 different sounds are represented in 40 different phonemes. This is all about the acoustic model. That means here in acoustic model, you must remember that this model takes the input as the speech in digital format. After that, it detects the sound in statistical representation. And here the statistical representation of sound is called as phonemes. And in your English language, there is 40 different sounds and each sounds are represented in phonemes. Next one is the language model. The language model is nothing but it is a model which detects the language of our speech which given input to the system. Here, language models are used to limit the search in a decoder by limiting the number of possible words that are required to consider at any one point in the search. Finally, the result is faster execution and higher accuracy of the model. That means when we use the language model, that language model basically detects the language of our speech. After that, it generates the word and it giving this word to the speech engine. Next, speech recognition techniques. The main objective of speech recognition is for a machine to be able to listen, understand, and act upon the information provided through the voice input. Which means, here, the main goal or the main aim of our speech recognition is that the machine can listen, understand, and act upon the information which is provided to the machine by voice input. Next, automatic speaker recognition aims to analyze, extract, characterize, and recognize information about the speaker's identity. That means when we perform the speech recognition process, at the speech recognition process, there is an automatic speaker recognition. And here this automatic speaker recognition main aim is to analyze, extract and characterize the information which is provided as input. Next, the speaker recognition system works in three stages. First one is the analysis, second one is the feature extraction and third one is the modeling. First we discuss about the speech analysis technique. In speech analysis technique, first, the speaker identity can be shown by a different type of information that is present in speech data. That means in our speech recognition process, first we identify the speaker, and here the speaker identity can be shown in different type of information which is present in our speech data. This incorporates speaker-specific information due to the vocal tract, excitation, source, and behavior feature. That means when we use the speaker identity, here the speaker-specific information is provided due to the vocal tract, excitation source, and the behavior feature. Next, this stage deals with a suitable frame size for segmenting speech signal for further analysis and extracting. Next one is the feature extraction technique. The speech feature extraction technique is the process of placing words in groups or classes. It's about decreasing the dimensionality of the input vector while maintaining the discriminating power of the signal. That means Here, the feature extraction is the process where we basically place the words of our speech in groups or classes for decreasing the dimensionality of the input vector. Next, from the basic formation of speaker identification and verification system, we know that the number of training and the test vector needed for the classification problem grows with the dimension of the given input. Therefore, we need feature extraction of the speech signal. That means, in speech recognition, we perform feature extraction because when we perform the speaker identification or verification, at that timing the training and testing vectors grows with the dimension of the given input. For this reason, we perform the feature extraction where we place the words in groups or classes. Next is modeling. The modeling technique aims to create speaker models using a speaker specific feature vector. Further, speaker recognition and speaker identification are the parts of the modeling. That means here in modeling, basically we create a speaker model using a speaker specific feature vector. The speaker identification technique identifies by itself who is speaking based on individual information integrated into a speech signal. That means in speaker identification technique, it identifies who is speaking. Next, types of speech recognition software. First one is the speaker dependent. Here, those individuals who will be using the system train the speaker dependent system, and these systems are capable of achieving a higher, better command count than 95% accuracy for word recognition. That means the speaker dependent is nothing but here the input speech is dependent on the speaker, and this is basically identifies who is speaking. Next, the drawback of this approach is that the system only responds accurately only to the individual who trained the system. That means in the speaker dependent technique, here the input voice is dependent on the speaker who is speaking. That means who is training the system, that individual voice can be accurately recognized. And this is the most common approach implemented in software for personal computers. Since this is the process of a speaker dependent, and this speaker dependence process is only applicable for the personal computer, because here the speaker is a specific person who trained the system, and that speaker input can only be processed. Next one is the speaker independent. Here, speaker independent is a system trained to respond to a word regardless of who is speaking. That means in speaker independent, in this case, it responds to the word without knowing about who is speaking that word. That means it basically focused on the speech, not the speaker who is speaking or who is giving this speech as input. Therefore, the system must respond to a large variety of speech patterns, inflections and enunciations are of the target word. Next, the common word count is generally lower than the speaker dependent, whereas high accuracy can still be maintained with processing limits. And industrial requirements need speaker independent voice system more often, such as the AT&T system are used in the telephone system, which means the speaker independent technique is basically used by the industrial requirement, where the speaker identification is not required, only the speech recognition is required. Now, Here you remember that what is the difference between speaker dependent and speaker independent technique. In speaker dependent technique, it is focused on the speaker who is speaking or who is giving this speech as input. But in our speaker independent technique, it depends on the word or the speech which is spoken by the speaker. Next, example of speech recognition. In car system, simple voice commands used to initiate phone calls and select radio station or play music from a compatible smartphone, MP3 player or music loaded flash drive. In addition, voice recognition capability vary between car make and model. That means here this is one of the example of our speech recognition which is basically used in our car for dialing the number or for dialing the music through the voice input. Next, conclusion of the speech recognition. Here, speech is the primary and most convenient way for people to communicate. We are at a turning point where voice and natural language understanding are suddenly at the forefront. And the main goal of speech recognition area is to develop techniques and systems for speech input to the machine. That means here speech recognition is required because speech is the convenient way through which the people can communicate. So that we want to develop a speech recognition technique through which the machine or the computer can recognize the human being speech, and according to that speech it performs its task. Since humans do a daily activity of speech recognition, it is one of the most consolidating area of machine intelligence. And speech recognition has created a technological impact on society, further expected to flourish in this area of human-machine interaction. With significant advance in voice technology, user will now need to spend less time performing lengthy search or transcribing huge voice data to text transcripts. That means the speech recognition gives us the advantage of giving input through the voice or through speech without writing some lengthy query. Next, it is imperative that this new technology also establish a new mark in the construction of brand through new age voice dynamics enabled by the artificial intelligence. More innovative can offer companies in the field of speech recognition a wide horizon of opportunity to explore. This is all about the speech recognition in artificial intelligence. Here, in speech recognition, you must remember that the main aim of speech recognition is that the computer can understand the voice or speech of a human being, and according to that voice it performs its task. If you have any doubt regarding this speech recognition process, then you can ask me through comment. I will reply you and discuss about your doubt. Thank you for watching.